I was very young when I first saw her in the office.
Officially, she was an office superintendent working the clerical section. But really, she was there to help people.
I used to sit on the table. I used to watch her. I remember that I used to feel very happy while I was there.
जब नौकरी में हम आए थे 73 में उस वक्त हम लोग को लगा कि सरकारी नौकरी मिल गई है गवर्नमेंट जॉब है और अब हमारी लाइफ सिक्योर हो गई हम सुविधाएं भी देते थे काम भी कराते थे उनसे और उनको हर मामले फैमिली में कई प्रॉब्लम्स होती वहाँ भी हल करते थे ऑफिस की भी प्रॉब्लम हल हो जाती थी तो कोशिश मेरी ये होती थी मेरा एम्प्लॉय किसी भी मामले में परेशान ना हो
I wanted to follow in my grandmother's footsteps, help people who work in railways. But it was different for me. I work in HR, so I can see what has changed.
When she was working, there was not a single area which was privatized. But now, cleaner, track maintainers and the catering also. They're all casual laborers now.
They're working on half pay and they're not getting any of the facilities that we are getting.
I don't think I will be able to survive in my work without that safety and security of allowances that I get. In my office also, the recruitment has been closed. I'm seeing people leave, but other people are not coming. Nowadays, we feel very burdened.
All this cost cutting is done in a very sly manner. It's done in a very subtle manner. You don't see its impact directly on people. And yet, every year you see more and more jobs are outsourced, which means it has been an indirect entry of private workers.
In our job area also, I don't know what will come after 5 years because the scenario has just changed. That thought scares me because today we've got an income which comes on the first of every month. We can think about our future. But if railways get privatized, the security has just gone out of the job. It will be very difficult go ahead and plan life.
ITF workshops help a lot to make people realize that there's something like this is going to happen and we have to fight against it together.
We have to fight against it because it will take our jobs, it will take our livelihood. We have to protect our future generations. I have to because I feel secure today because of her. So I think people who are coming after me should also feel the same thing.